हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट बटरवर्थ फिल्टर एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 36329। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। सो दिस इज द बटरवर्थ फिल्टर किट एंड हियर वी आर हैविंग फर्स्ट ऑर्डर लो पास फिल्टर सर्किट, देन दिस इज द सेकेंड ऑर्डर लो पास फिल्टर सर्किट, देन दिस इज द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर हाई पास फिल्टर सर्किट, देन दिस इज द सेकेंड ऑर्डर हाई पास फिल्टर सर्किट एंड दीज आर द potentiometer ports which we can vary to observe the waveforms at the output ports. So these are the output ports of all the filters and these are the input ports of all the filters and this is the circuitry diagram. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study the Butterworth first order low pass filter. So for that we have to do the connections first. Now we will switch on the kit and we will switch on the DSO and function generator. And now for first order low pass filter we have to give 1 kilohertz sine wave at the input port of the first order low pass filter circuit and we have to observe the waveform at the output port of this circuit. So we can observe the output waveforms on the DSO. So now we will connect the function generator at the input end like this and here we are giving sine wave of 1 kilohertz and now we will observe the output waveform at the output terminal like this. So here you can see that on the DSO we can see the waveform. So by using this port we can vary the frequency of the waveform. So here the frequency is 1 kilohertz and now we can vary the amplitude, that is around 380 and now it is reducing to 260. So by using this port we can vary the amplitude and we can also increase the frequency or decrease the frequency by using the function generator. So when we increase or decrease the frequency we can observe the output at the DSO. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study second order low pass filter. So for that we have to do the connections first. So now we have to give input at the input ports. So we are giving input as sine wave of 1 kilohertz. So at second order low pass filter circuit we will give input at the input ports and we will observe the output at the output ports by using this DSO. So firstly we have to connect this R2 with the ground of second order low pass filter like this and now we will give input of sine wave of 1 kilohertz frequency and now we will observe the output at the output terminals. So firstly switch on the kit and now we will connect the probes to the output end and here on the DSO you can see the waveform. So by using this port you can vary the amplitude of the waveform and if you want to increase or decrease the frequency you can use this function generator for increasing or decreasing the frequency. The output will behave similar to the input supplied. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study first order high pass filter. So for that we have to do the connections first. So now we will switch on the kit and we will give input at the first order high pass filter input ports. So at input we are giving sine wave of 1 kilohertz. So we will connect the probes at the input port of the circuit like this and now we will observe the output at the output terminals of the first order high pass filter. So we will connect the probes at the output end like this. And now we will use this port to vary the amplitude. So when we vary the amplitude, we can observe the waveform on the DSO. So by using this port, you can increase or decrease the amplitude of the waveform. So when you rotate it in clockwise direction, the amplitude will increase, and when you decrease the amplitude, you have to rotate it in anti-clockwise direction. So for decreasing the amplitude, you have to rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, and for increasing it, you have to rotate it in clockwise direction, and you can observe the changes on the DSO. You can also vary the frequency by using the function generator. So that is how you can perform this experiment, and you can also plot the graph between frequency and voltage, and you can also form the table between frequency and voltage, and you can also find the value of magnitude by using the formula that is mentioned in the manual. Similarly, you can perform the experiment for the second order high pass filter. The connections are specified in the manual, and these are the input ports and these are the output ports. So at input ports, you have to give the sine wave from the frequency generator, and at the output ports, you can observe the waveform by using this DSO. And similarly, you can plot the graph between frequency and voltage, and you can also find the magnitude by using the formula specified in the manual. So that is how you can perform all the experiments. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact our Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.